Hi, I'm Steph.
And I'm Greg.
We're the Google Wave team. You know us. We're the people who made an 80-minute video to tell you about our product. Here's our attempt to tell you what Wave is in only 10 minutes. Don't be mad if we try to smoosh a lot in. Wave can do a lot of things. Wave was built in Sydney, Australia. Lars and Jens started the project. They helped create Google Maps. This is what computers looked like when email was invented more than 40 years ago. Technology has advanced pretty far since then. We took inspiration from all these innovations and tried to imagine what email would look like if it were invented today. Out popped Wave. Here's how Wave is different from email. When you send an email, everyone gets a copy of the message. A Wave is a hosted conversation. There's one copy and anyone can contribute to it. This model allows you to do many types of communication and collaboration in one tool. Let's say I want to plan a barbecue with my friends. I'll create a new Wave, and I'll add Greg as a participant. Greg opens the Wave. Greg can reply anywhere in the Wave. When I have the Wave open, I can see what Greg types as he types it. I'll add Anna to the Wave. She can see everything we see. Because it's a hosted conversation, anyone on the Wave can edit any part of the Wave. You can see Greg and Anna editing right now. If I close the Wave and they keep editing it, their changes will be highlighted when I come back. Let's say I want to invite my friends to the barbecue. I'll create a new Wave. I want to know if they can attend, so I'm going to add a yes, no, maybe gadget to this Wave. Gadgets are a way to present and collect information other than text. Now I'll add a group of my friends to the Wave, the Wavers. Everyone in the group can see the Wave when they are in line and respond. You can see responses coming in now. Why does Dan always say no to my barbecues? If I want to show people where the barbecue is, I can highlight the address and add a map. As I zoom in, you can see Greg's map changes too. Any developer can build these gadgets.
People always want to drag and drop files directly from their desktop into web applications. With Wave, you can. Watch as Stephanie creates a new Wave and then drag and drops a bunch of photos from iPhoto directly into Wave. Thumbnails will appear on my machine as soon as they start uploading on hers. I can then drag and drop photos from my machine directly into the Wave as well. You can see at the bottom of the screen, there's an images menu. This menu allows you to operate on all of the images in the Wave, not just the images you added. This is an easy and convenient way to make a collaborative photo album using Wave. Now that we have a Wave with lots of images in it, we want to share it with our friends. Mm-hmm. Drag our friend Bloggy onto the Wave. This will publish the Wave on Steph's blog. Embedding is an easy way to put Waves directly into any website, much the same way you can do with Maps today. Watch as I go to Steph's blog. You can see on Steph's blog that we embed the whole Wave, not just the images. This includes all of the UI. Watch as I leave a comment. Everything that I type on the blog immediately appears in Steph's Wave client. Steph can respond in her Wave client, and her typing immediately appears on the blog. Since I contributed to the blog, the Wave will also show up in my Wave client, and we can continue the conversation from there. Embedding Waves is good for developers because it allows them to drop a rich collaborative UI into websites with very little code. It's great for users because it allows them to have a consistent UI as well as aggregate conversations they care about all in one place.
The combination of collaborative editing and inline discussion makes Wave a powerful platform for document creation. I'll show you that by opening a design doc we wrote on our team. I'll make a little more room. And you can see this has rich fonts, it has diagrams, it has inline discussion. The best way to view a Wave when it's picked up a certain amount of structure is using a feature we built called Playback. Playback tells you how the Wave built up. Steven, our trusted server guy, wrote a draft. He added a bunch of people. Lars, the manager, said it's a good start but needs more. Steven added more. I made some edits and so on. I can pick up this slider and move to any part of the Wave. playback is a powerful way to investigate and manipulate the history of a wave.
Robots are pieces of software that can be added to a wave like a participant, and in fact can act like a participant. They can do anything a person can do on the wave. They can watch the typing that's going on, they can add other participants to the wave, and in fact they can even write into the wave.
Let me show you another extension to Wave that lets you interface to a different communication system. I'll start a new wave, and I'll add my friend Tweety the Twitbot. As you can see, Tweety puts in a form. I'm going to sign in with my Twitter username and password. Unfortunately, it's Twefany. When I submit that form, the robot notices it and goes and uses Twitter's API to get updates from the people I follow. I can also put in my own update. Tweety notices that and uses the Twitter APIs to update my Twitter account. You can also use Tweety to search over the public timeline of Twitter. Imagine there's a phrase I care a lot about, like Google Wave. I can enter it here, and Tweety will use the API to pull in tweets with that word in them. This way, you can use Tweety to be an alert or alarm for a phrase you care about. I can actually leave this wave in my account, and anytime there's a new match, this wave will become active for me. I can open it and see the new content. Robots can be used to interface to other systems. In this case, it was Twitter, but it could be anything with an API.
Imagine Steph and I are friends. I only speak French, she only speaks English, but we want to communicate in real time. Rosie's a robot that interfaces into Google's translation engine and allows us to translate everything in a wave in real time if we'd like to. I'm set up for French, Steph's set up for English. I'll add Rosie to the wave and then say hi to her. Bonjour, Steph. As you can see, it comes up for Steph in English. What Steph types comes up for me in French. Je voudrais visite au Paris. So you see that Steph and I can communicate with each other in real time, even though we don't speak the language, using robots, Wave, and our buddy Rosie.
Whew. Oh God. 10 minutes goes by fast.
Oh my God. It was like forever. Jeez. Is it still rolling?
Still rolling. Mm. Thanks, Greg.
Yeah, sure. Good job.
Good job.